Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude. You have been
warned. Hey guys and gals, James here, aka Wade Demon Gittis, and today on Gaming Theater we're going to be looking at Space Beast Terror of Fright. This is a early access game on Steam for $14.99 or your regional equivalent. Nornware AB was kind enough to give me a copy of the game to take a look at this. This is a roguelike where it's like old school first person shooter mixed with some alien elements in there, like space marine, alien elements. And fun little fact, this is actually kind of cool, is there is single player, but there's local co-op up to four players. One on keyboard and the rest on controllers, or I think, if I'm not mistaken, you could all be on controllers. And the game is actually pretty simplistic in its design scheme, is go around, collect the data you need, and leave. Don't die. You die, you start over from the beginning. So that's literally, there you go. All right, let's get into it. Now, this is one of those games where it's not going to be for everybody. That's just the facts. That is just the facts. Alright, so, situation, vessel infested by xenomorphs. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I thought that was copyrighted, but that's okay. I'm calling the kettle black here. Data cores online. You must proceed into the heart of the infested spacecraft to find and download the data cores. Sentries are available for strategic defense. When all data cores have been downloaded, disable the reactor coolants and proceed to the airlock. Oh wow. Oh, ooh, they updated with an easy mode because the game's only been on hard, and like I got to the last data core and I died. Oh god, did I die? I had Cal help me out, and it's much easier with players, like friends, of course, because they're watching your back, they're covering your six. But in this, we're actually gonna go on easy. Cause hard's like, holy crap. Alright, so as you can tell, the gun models in this game are huge. If you have an issue with size, well, obviously, don't fret. Alright. Looks pretty good. A little minigun right here, it's pretty badass. If you guys notice, my flashlight has like a 60 second charge, so it's really, really helpful for you to go around and get these data cores, because they're going to give you additional energy for your flashlight and ammo. That's kind of helpful, and it's also your mission, so it's even more helpful. I think my only gripe so far with the game has been the fact that the motion sensor on the bottom doesn't detect as quickly as I'd like. Good example is you hear motion, you see, or you first you hear the combat music, and then motion kind of just bleeps and then you're dead. As in, they rip right through under the ground and kill you. But it's still in early access, so that is a thing you gotta kind of factor in. Also, the game is designed to be difficult. Like, difficult. Oh, that's right. Okay, so hold up. I don't know if you guys saw it, but I'm gonna reduce the FOV all the way down to the bottom, because here's what happens. The longer that you're in combat, the FOV gets farther and farther out, okay? Some people like to have their FOV automatically really far out so they can see almost 180 degrees, if not more, right? Me, I get motion sickness when I go past a certain point. So having it like flick between trying to go into that 180, if not more, and then try to stay where it's at, it causes me to get sick, so I have to shut off FOV. That's just something you guys should be aware of, and just kind of, yeah. Also, you might want to have muzzle flare down, because even at that small, that takes up quite a bit. Alright. Something's picking up motion. I got motion. Somewhere. I don't see it, though. It's getting closer. Also, okay, where's the motion? Side note, as I was gonna say, is more data cores basically give you upgrades, so you become stronger. Okay, where's the motion, baby? There's the motion of the ocean. It gets close and then it goes away. It gets close and then it's like, there it is. There you go. Okay. The problem is it didn't pop up on my motion sensor. I'm gonna get the turret. I'm gonna go for the turret first. Here we go. I don't have a safety buddy. These turrets are my safety buddies. The great thing is you can have all of them on too. There's no negative to it. Which I could see them for harder difficulties. Being like, all right, you can only have a set amount of sentry turrets on. Or you have to pull energy from one to the other. Which means you could potentially make one stronger than the other. Insane how this game makes you feel panicky, though. I mean, that's a good sign, but holy crap. And of course, the game's on easy. But originally, when I played this, the game... Whoa! Okay. When I originally played this game, was stuck on hard, so... My life expectancy was a minute and a half. Okay, where is it? Woo, good! Are they breaking? Okay! Are they breaking through? Just open the door. There's a turret! Give me my turret! And as far as I know, Friendly Fire is on, so if you happen to play with your friends, because you only need really one copy unless you want to play online. Actually, I don't even think they support online at the moment. So when you do play with your friends, Friendly Fire is on. Keep that in mind. Unless you want to be a jerk. In which case, have at it. Okay, where's it? Let's break it somewhere. Keeps breaking. Yeah! You know what? We're gonna go a different way. Go a different way here. Gimme. No! Woo! Woo! Little shit in a handbasket. There's gotta be a turret around here somewhere, right? Yeah! I mean, it's like the worst spot to put it, but that's okay. Did I mention the levels are randomized? I didn't? Oh, they are. I guess there's one down there. Okay, I guess it's not as bad as I thought. It's just that's not really gonna help me with this problem. That's a big problem. That is a big ass problem. Okay, so he's kind of got my back on that side. Oh my god. Captain, you got a bit of a problem here. I'm hunching. It's not good for the back. Oh my god, the Gib Factor. I have no idea where they're coming from! No, that's happened. Okay, so I actually survived a lot longer than I anticipated. I know it says easy in like undeniably large letters that would explain that I suck, but this has been Space Beast Terror Fright. You can get it right now in early access for $14.99 or your regional equivalent already. When I played this, the game only had the hard mode, the one mode. They are ramping up, adding modes, adding different difficulty settings for you to play with. I mean, I like it. It's a roguelike. It's a first-person shooter. It harkens back to older times. Not everybody's going to like it, and then not everybody's going to feel that the game's fair. The game's not supposed to be fair. It's, in many ways, a game where you overcome a extreme challenge, an extreme obstacle that can be viewed as a bit of a bitch. Let's be honest, that's how we thought Demon's Souls and Dark Souls was. They still are today. So you can kind of get that sense of feel, the same vein. And if that's what they're trying to go for, they're already starting to capture a glimmer and a glimpse of that, which keep it up, guys. All right, leave a comment below, let me your thoughts on the video. And as always, guys, catch you next time. Hey guys, make sure you check out the videos below for more happy fun times. And if you already haven't, hit that subscriber button to let you know when more happy moments are coming to you on my channel. And finally, if you haven't, hit the like button. Gives you chocolate. No, I'm actually lying. Wish I could give you chocolate. Chocolate.